Jacksonville might be one of the Sunshine State's best kept secrets. And today we've got an exciting video. We're gonna talk about 9 new build 55 plus options. I'd like to introduce you to Michele on our team Explore 55 Plus. She knows all of these communities very well, and you're gonna kind of be our liaison for the video.
Okay.
So to start off, we'll talk about Del Webb Nocatee, which the first time I saw it kind of blew my mind. It's one of the most stunning communities I've seen, and I know you live pretty close to it, so you're super familiar with the area and stuff.
Yeah, exactly.
So each of these communities, we'll talk about basically all the information you guys need. We're gonna talk about the amenities, the lifestyle they provide. We'll talk about some pricing and then maybe some pros and cons if anything stands out in the communities. But for Del Webb Nocatee, in terms of an overview, what would you say?
Okay, so Del Webb Nocatee it started in, I wanna say 2019. It's a beautiful entry, very coastal. The amenity center there is stunning. It has a beautiful fire pit. It has an outdoor lap pool that's heated. It has a beautiful pool. They all have the beach entrance. Has a great fire pit. One of the things I think is awesome about it is it's the first one that I saw here that has an indoor-outdoor cafe
restaurant
and bar. And don't quote me on the exact number, 800 and change people.
Mm-hmm. So in terms of pricing and ballpark pricing, just to give someone an idea, and we'll throw this information up on the screen, to give someone an idea of maybe a starting point in terms of your budget, so there's no surprises.
Right.
And then HOA, CDD, some of that stuff. Okay. And then style of homes that are available.
In this particular Del Webb community, they build a villa, which is 2 homes together. Very nice, they're about 1550 square feet. Those start at 451. Now, I'm gonna give you the starting prices on these, but I usually ask the agent, what do people typically spend on upgrades? You don't have to spend anything, and it'll be that 451.
Yeah, but you gotta always get talked into something.
Well, most people are gonna do something. Flooring, countertops. So they say 15%. And then they have lot premiums.
So safe starting point is low fives.
Low fives, I would say, in the Del Webb Nocatee. The next one up is the Classic. The starting on those is in the 550. So by the time you add, you're gonna be in the sixes. Then they do the Estates. Those start in the sevens, and I've seen those up into the nines. They typically have incentives on closing costs. They don't always have incentives on options.
Builders will change the incentives all the time, and it depends where they are in their year, so you just have to really know what's going on with incentives. The closing cost incentives typically are if you use their financing. So, and there's pros and cons to using their financing to getting your own financing. So anyway, lots of details when you have a new build.
So they're in Del Webb. Now, the thing about the villas is their HOA fee is $375 a month. But you have to remember that includes, so the Del Webb communities here do not include lawn care on your single family homes. The Del Webb, the villas do include lawn care. So in that $375, they cover the termite bond, your lawn care, and those reserves. So that, the normal HOA fee in Del Webb is $216. This one is a little bit more because it
shared
has
expenses.
That extra stuff.
Both of those sound super reasonable.
In a home with your HOA and your CDD, you're looking at about $425 a month. In the villas, you're looking closer to $550. Yeah, so Nocatee is a golf cart community. You can take the golf cart not only all around the Del Webb, but you can take it, they have golf cart path all the way up, all the way through all of Nocatee. Because the thing about Nocatee is you're part of that community development district, so you have access to all of the amenities, all the pools, all the water parks. Mm-hmm. So the cool thing is that all of that by golf cart.
All that. Not only that, then public shopping,
restaurants,
doctor's offices, all of that.
Yep.
But they don't have access to Del Webb.
Next community is Water, and this is kind of a, they have like a longer name. Mattamy Homes, WaterSong at RiverTown.
Right. Okay, so just a little background. Mattamy is a Canadian company.
Gross. No, I'm just kidding.
So they build regular homes. It's a planned community just like before. Mm-hmm. And then WaterSong is an active adult community within that. I'm going to talk about the master plan community first because they have this beautiful river house. So you drive up, there's a restaurant, there's the fitness center, there's all this beautiful outdoor seating, there's this amazing pool, and then you walk down and there's a dock down on the river where you can just go enjoy just being on the river.
That is the one thing that it seems like they preserve a ton of nature around here with these communities.
Well, St. John's County, these are, most of what we're gonna be talking about today is in St. John's County. They are very strict about a certain amount of green space. You can only develop a certain amount of space. Okay, so they also have villas that start in the 350 range. 50%. Again, you're 15%. I mean, you're still gonna do some upgrades to those. And then they have single family that start in the 1,500 square foot at about 380.
Okay.
It's pretty affordable, mm-hmm. actually.
Right.
You're still thinking around 400 plus, though, as your starting point.
With your lot, yeah. Mm-hmm. And the fees there are about $320 a month with your HOA and your CDD. You're probably 20 minutes from Durban Pavilion, which has a ton of stores. You're probably 35 minutes from, we have the Jacksonville Town Center. Almost everyone is gonna be 40 minutes away from that. They have everything from Target to Louis Vuitton.
All right, this next one, in my opinion, uh-huh. I can say that because I'm not an agent.
Right.
That's
right.
True.
I can be as biased as I want. So Del Webb, eTown.
Oh, eTown, okay.
It's a funky community.
Well, you know, it is. And I think I had a customer one time say, why is it called eTown? And I can't remember what the explanation was like, but it was like cutting edge, right?
I mean, trying to be the future.
Yeah.
Like, it's totally green.
It is also a master plan community, right? So you've got Del Webb within that. That community is probably the most convenient community to everything.
Okay.
Maybe not to the beach, but it's not that far from the beach. But shopping, airport.
So right downtown next. Jacksonville.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, it's
stadiums,
right,
the
exactly,
shows.
Exactly. So in eTown, they do not build the villas. They build, and I think anybody who's been to a Del Webb community knows, you've got garden, classic, and estate. Mm-hmm. That's the typical. So they do the garden, and so the garden, say 1,350 square feet, and in eTown those start at 425. So classic is, they're starting at like 495, and then the estates are like 565. So you figure it's 710 for an estate in Nocatee, it's 565 for an estate in eTown.
Okay, yeah, yeah.
There, yeah.
Now in that community, you have access to the Del Webb amenities. You don't have access to the eTown amenities. They've got, you know, sports courts, they've got a game room, they've got a clubhouse, they've got a beautiful pool, fitness center. And those fees are $370 a month. So they're definitely lower than in the Del Webb, mm-hmm. Nocatee community. You know, your taxes are a little higher in Duval County.
Okay.
Not that much higher.
Okay, next one's exciting because I think it's our first one so far that has a proper golf course.
Oh, yes.
Stillwater.
Yes, Stillwater.
All right,
okay,
let's talk
so,
about it.
Stillwater is, it is the only 55 plus community that has a golf course.
In Jacksonville.
It's the only 55 plus community. So Stillwater right now, just so you know, they have, they have non-resident members. They have resident members, they have non-resident members. Once the community is built out, it's my understanding that
they go to private.
It will be up to the community whether they want it to be private, and I think that's going to all be all about the numbers of having to support and maintain a golf course, right?
Yeah.
That is a Lennar community. So with Lennar, it's like everything's included. Now you don't go to a Lennar community and say, "Oh, I love this lot and I want this model and I want these cabinets and I want this." It doesn't work like that. So with Lennar, they have their lots. They permit them with specific home sites. So if I go in and I say, I want a charl, I like that plan. The only thing that you can upgrade is you can upgrade flooring and you can upgrade your appliance package. You can have the luxury package, which is a double oven, cooktop, refrigerator.
Wow.
So that's the kind of con to that. The pro is that
it
you know what the price is.
Too.
Yeah, you know what the price is. And so like you can only get white cabinets now. That's all they do. They used to do white, gray, and brown. I think that most people picked out white. So they do villas and they do single family. And the pricing there goes from like $370 up to maybe $520.
Okay.
Then if you wanted to add, I mean, it might be a little more than $520 if they have put the kitchen and the flooring in that one, right? So the fees, right now the clubhouse has not been started. So they have pickleball courts. I think they just opened
cool.
the pool. They have like three, I think, trailers right now that they use for the clubhouse.
Oh, they
say that the clubhouse is probably 18 months out. Mm-hmm. So if people don't mind that, right when the clubhouse is finished, and I think there's a forgiveness in the fee right now because there's no clubhouse, it's going to be $700 a month.
Ooh.
Wow.
Because you've got a golf course. You know, you got a golf course.
But so. You get to play golf for nothing.
Yeah, I mean, if you're going to join a golf club here, first of all, you can't really get
it's
into
not
a
optional.
Golf club.
The club. Mm-hmm. Wow. Okay.
Ah, so this is
most
legit
of the time.
Golf
most of the time,
community.
It is optional. So
right.
This is yeah. This is like a.
Yeah, this is a. I mean, if you're. If
so
you're,
they've got to know then if they fill all the lots that they can probably go private with it just based on the amount of homes they're going to have available, mm-hmm. right?
Yeah,
that's
I mean,
a pretty good idea.
Yeah, and then the cart fee, is. $30. So if you want to take your cart out, you pay $30.
Wow. So it's
if you want to take your cart out or their cart?
Any cart. I mean a cart fee.
Cart,
a cart
in
fee.
General.
I don't know
so
if
you,
they're
so
going to
have.
So if
you pay the $700, you're still paying
$30 cart fee. Trail fee. Uh huh. That is. I mean, but it's a great option.
But your only
for
golf
some
option.
Serious golfers. That's your only 55 plus option.
Yeah. And it is a beautiful golf course.
Mm-hmm.
It really was.
It is, yeah. It's a really nice golf course.
All right, so this is Del Webb Wildlight.
Okay, so Wildlight is another master plan community. When I talked to the agent most recently, he said it's like a 40, 50 year project, right?
Oh, wow.
Ooh.
Not the Del Webb part, but just Wildlight in general, because I think it's going to go, I want to say it's going to go all the way to the river, to the St. Mary's River.
Oh, wow.
Eventually.
Oh.
Right now, there's the Del Webb at Wildlight. Which is, it's a great little community. They have finished their amenity center. It's gonna be like the Canopy Club in Nocatee. So it will have the bar and grill. It'll look just like that. It might have a little bit different flair on the exterior. And at some point there is gonna be like a food minimum that they're gonna charge every month. I think it's gonna be like $40 or something, but who's not gonna use $40 worth of
yeah.
stuff, right? The villas there start at $367.
Okay.
As opposed to, you're about almost 100,000 less than Nocatee. They have villas, they have classic, I mean, villas, garden, classic, and estate there. So the garden homes are 371,000 starting, 1,300 some square feet. The classics start at 436, that's about 1,550 square feet, something like that. And then the estates start at 541. So again, Del Webb Nocatee is 710 on the estates, 541 on the estates.
Mm. Same house, different land costs, basically.
Same house, different land costs.
And you said the amenities for this particular Del Webb are built already?
They will be finished in December.
Okay, well, okay. That's right around
and they're gonna have the pickleball, they're gonna have the bocce ball. Now, Wildlight, from what I understand, is not gonna have like a huge amenity thing like Nocatee. They are going to have more like little neighborhoods with little shopping areas within the neighborhoods and a lot of outdoor trails and stuff like that, but no huge amenities. So you go to Wildlight. Wildlight is technically in Yulee. Okay, so Yulee is just outside of historic Fernandina Beach and off of Amelia Island. So you're 15 minutes from the airport. You're 2.5 hours from Savannah if you want to go there. So
15 minutes from the airport? Mm-hmm. Does that mean when you're out there?
No. You're 15 minutes. No, you don't. No, because it's here.
The flight path's
yeah.
a different way.
No, yeah. Okay. I don't even know that. When you're ready, then it's a good time to see what the incentives are.
Yes.
If you're not ready and you know what the incentives are, then when you come back
don't
in a year
yourself.
And they don't have those incentives, then you go, why don't they have those incentives? But
yeah. To wrap Wildlight up,
because
it's obviously
fees.
Oh, you want to do the fees?
Yeah, so the fees, again, the villas, the fees there are about $533 a month because it's the same. It includes the lawn, termite bond, reserves for all that other stuff. And then the fees for the houses, single family homes, is about $425.
Lakeview at Tributary.
Yeah. Okay, so Lakeview. So Lakeview is about 3 miles west of Wildlight, under 95. It's part of a planned community called Tributary. Tributary is a beautiful community. It's, again, it's mixed with, you know, regular houses, and then you've got Lakeview, which is just this little part. They have a nice pool. They have a beautiful fitness center. They have the sports courts, trails, dog parks. Lakeview is within that community, again, I think about 500 homes, and it is Lennar. So again, it's like everything's included. So pricing in there, you can get into a home in Lakeview, and they're all single family. They don't have villas there. For, I want to say $325.
Ooh. So this is probably your most affordable option. Mm-hmm.
Single family, 1544 square feet. They're in their last phase. They expect that to be sold out in August.
Oh, wow. Okay. Crunch time.
Yeah.
Chop, chop.
And they don't have their amenities yet. They think it's probably going to be.
I'll be darned.
They don't have their amenities. They have, you have the Wildlight.
Okay.
I mean, the.
It's kind of nice with those master plans, because then it's like, okay, well, you guys can all use that stuff until we can get.
Right. Yeah, that is nice. So, I mean, they said probably next year, and they'll probably be out of here. They'll probably be sold out by August, and then they'll build out. You know, that's going to take longer than selling, obviously.
Here you go. Across the board, do they all allow fences?
So they typically allow the wrought iron, not the wrought iron, the aluminum, black aluminum.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, is there any out of the nine that don't, do you know?
Well, I will tell you where you don't, where you can't have a fence is on a villa. None of the villas allow fences.
Hmm. But otherwise you can.
I don't know of any community that doesn't allow you to fence with the black. The fees at the Tributary at Lakeside, Lakeside are $230 a month.
Oh,
wow. So, okay.
So yeah. I mean, it's very affordable housing wise and
you just got to mow your own lawn.
Is the location?
Well, I mean,
farther out. What makes it more affordable?
It's only probably 3 miles further out from from Fernandina Beach.
And we're going to have an asset for you guys too. We'll talk more about it at the end. Just a reminder. We're going to put just a sheet together with this stuff. So we'll talk more about that at the end. We've got two more communities to get through.
Okay. So Parkland Preserve, if you are familiar with D.R. Horton's Freedom brand, that's their 55 plus, they are located actually very close to World Golf Village, 5 minutes from the new Costco. You're right off the interstate to get anywhere you want to go.
Michele, D.R. Horton is also a production builder.
Yes. They are, so 1,600 square feet, $376 is the kind of go-in price there. And then the fees there are $311 a month. Now they don't have as beefed up communities, right? They have a clubhouse, they have pickleball, fitness.
Only $367.
Oh, okay. Yeah, so they're probably just about, I would think they'd be just about done in there.
Yeah.
I'm not sure. The only con to that community is it is close to 95, so I don't know about road noise. You know, some people are more sensitive. Of course, you know, the thing is, it's a big empty field right now, so when you get houses,
it kind of dampens.
I mean, I live right off of 210, so if I'm in my driveway, I live close to Nocatee, if I'm in my driveway and I listen, I can hear 210, but I don't go out and try to listen. I mean, I don't even notice it anymore.
Well, then it becomes just sort of regular.
It's just white noise, kind of.
Yeah. I mean, is there anything else you want to add to it? It doesn't sound like there's.
I don't think so.
Again, affordable, but
it's affordable.
So people that have $400 as a budget, there's options.
All right, we're getting into the last two. We've got Reverie.
Let's do Reverie. So Reverie it's a dream finders community. They start, the smaller ones start 1,500 square feet, 363, 1,700 square feet, 401, and 2,200 square feet, 456. That's the base price going in. Again, you're talking probably 15 to 20% for upgrades. Mm-hmm. And then you've got a lot premium. So realistically, if you want to get in a medium-sized home on a nice lot with upgrades, you're going to be five.
Gotcha.
Probably.
Okay.
Their fees are $375 a month. They just opened their amenity center, and it's beautiful. They have the same, you know, fitness, beautiful clubhouse, beautiful pool. One of the amenities being a kayak launch and a canoe launch. So you can use that.
It has gotten more affordable. I mean, Nocatee and then everything else seems to be similar park. So if you have like around a $400,000 budget, you're starting out in a lot of these communities, and then Nocatee's that jump up there.
And then Summer Bay, that is not a Del Webb, that is a Pulte 55 plus community. Okay. Now they have a lot of the same plans. They have like the same, they have the garden, the estate, the classic. Garden starts at 320, classic 410, and their estate is 520. Now it's in, it's also in a master plan community, so you have access to Grand Oaks pools, trails, dog parks, fitness. But they're gonna have their own, they're also gonna have their own amenities. Mm-hmm. They all have, I'm sure they'll have an activities director.
So it's the fees, kind of pending on a lot of that stuff still though.
Yeah, they just finished, they're just finishing up their amenities, so their fees are $396 a month.
It seemed like this was a little further out from shopping and stuff too.
So straight down, you've got the outlet mall. Okay. This is 16. Follow 16 straight down the outlet mall, and then you can take that all the way into the city of St. Augustine. It's not really that
far. Another benefit of having somebody that's grown up in the place
that there's. You know how to get everywhere.
And then if you go up a little bit and take a right, you're going to be on International Golf Parkway, which is where the Costco and Bass Pro and 95. So that gets you to you know, wherever you want to go.
All right, thank you guys for taking the time to watch this video. It really does mean a lot to us.
Yes,
if you want to get connected with someone like Michele, who knows all the 55 plus communities in Jacksonville or in other areas in Florida, you can visit the website, explore55plus.com, or of course you can always call us, email us, text us, and
we'll take great care of you. Thanks for watching.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you.